think it's supposed to be, because I know how.
No, come on, Mom, be serious. No, nobody pays those things. Everybody on campus, I swear, they have at least three or four of them just laying around their cars. No, I know I'm not everyone else on campus. All right, okay, I will pay my parking tickets. I am not. All right, okay. I'll stop making faces at you over the phone. Yeah. No, you're right. I need to learn a little responsibility. And seriously, Mom, I am going to buckle down this time. I have 18 credits, and this is it for me, you know. It's all on the line right here, and I'm going to give you nothing but straight A's. I promise. Okay. All right, well, say hi to Dad. Okay. Uh-huh. Okay, bye.
Dave, listen. I have to go out of town tonight, so don't forget to take the limo to the airport and pick up the guest.
No.
Here you go. Here's the keys.
Wait.
Okay?
No.
All right. See ya.
Is got any gas in it?
No.
Dave, would you be a love and pick up my blouse at the cleaners? There's the ticket, and please don't forget it.
Dave, you need.
What?
Forgot. Dave, the general manager wants you to be sure to check the fluids in the car, and when you're done, wash the jet.
Yeah.
And polish it.
Yeah, sure.
Hey, Dave, here's that lunch list for the crew. We need 2 pepperoni, 3 Canadian bacon and pineapple, and Matt doesn't want any anchovies on his pizza, okay?
Yeah.
Oh, and don't forget the Coke. We only got 10 minutes, so hurry up.
Dave, I'll remember. Suzanne needs her dog taken to the vet at 3, okay?
Wait, it's 2:45 now.
Hey, Dave, here's the weekly condom joke. It's a good one.
All right, thanks.
Dave, this is the bio on a guest tonight. Be sure to read it.
Wait a minute, someone was supposed
to... No,
someone...
Be sure to read it.
Sure.
Hey, Dave, one of your dogs ripped the hell out of the Johnson Flower Garden again.
Which one?
Tammy Faye. But here's the lawyer stuff. He says you got to sign it and turn it in tomorrow morning. Right?
I don't have time to do this.
Hey, Dave, I realize you're awfully busy, but can you do me a favor and take out the trash?
Thanks. Yeah. Well, it's going to be a wonderful semester. Thank you. Come on. You guys don't have anything better to do than to come in here on a Friday night, your first week back from vacation, and you're in here? Yeah. Do you have anything better to do? Hey, welcome. Hey, it's second season. I guess you could technically call it our second season. This is our second semester, and we're excited about it, and we have got a show, let me tell you. All right. Last night, I want to get a little round of applause going here first. The Washington State Cougars last night clubbed Cal Berkeley 59-37. Now, the important thing about this is that they play Stanford tomorrow night, so flip them on the radio and give them a listen. They are a hot team this season. A lot of things going on in the news tonight, or today, rather. The first thing to take note of, I'm walking around campus. Everybody's having a tough time getting their classes now and, you know, standing in ad drop lines and all. And the new George Michael song, well, it's kind of new, is just taking the campus by storm. I've been walking around all week, and I've been hearing everybody sing it. It's called I Want Your Section. Yeah. Okay. There's an article in today's Evergreen, Live at 8 being as timely as it always is. They polled freshmen on this campus and compared them to freshman average nationally to find out what they thought about some issues. And the surprising thing is they found that WSU freshmen were, like, a lot different. They responded a lot differently than a lot of the students nationally. So we've got a few of the things that they found out on the study, and I'd just like to share them with you. First thing on the study, here we go. 50% of the freshmen polled nationally said that they agreed with a mandatory one-year live-in rule. Okay, we all understand that. But 30% of WSU students said that it was just too cold outside. All right. Wait, there's lots more. Okay, nationally, 77% of college freshmen believe the INF treaty is a step toward world peace, while 95% of WSU freshmen are encouraged that better relations between the two superpowers may lower vodka prices. Few WSU students in the audience. Nationally, freshmen voted flag football as the most popular intramural sport. Here at Washington State, co-ed tag team nude twister barely edged out relay rototilling. Okay, moving on here. 76% of college freshmen nationally polled agreed that the Iowa primary is an important indicator of the outcome of the presidential election. 60% of WSU freshmen responded, quote, Iowa, Indiana, Illinois, hell, all those I states are the same to us.
Ooh, a bowl of chili with hair in it.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, wait, a couple more here. Compared to the national average of 53%, 68% of WSU freshmen disagreed with Gary Hart's pulling out of and re-entering the race. Sorry. Okay. Nationally, 90% of freshmen polled agreed that the cost of a college education was indeed worthwhile. 95% of WSU freshmen said the rising cost of tuition really crimped their beer money. All right, we have a fantastic show tonight. We have a cartoonist from the Daily Evergreen with us. His name is Kevin Brockschmidt. He's a wonderful drawer. You should see some of the things he draws. We'll have a few things for you if you haven't seen them in the paper. We also have Mark Ermey and Randy Salison. I hope I did not pronounce your, or I hope I didn't mispronounce your name, Randy. And they will have a little skit for us. We have got just tons of stuff. Do not go away. Live at 8 will be right back. Second thought. A good move on their part. The following is a dramatization of what happens to those unlucky few who don't pay their optional lobby fee.
Excuse me, sir. May I see your lobby card?
My what?
Your lobby card. Without it, you cannot occupy university lobbies.
What are you talking about?
If you remember your tuition and fee statement, the part about the lobby fee?
Yeah, what about it? Did you pay it?
Well, no, it was optional. I don't have to pay it.
And in so choosing, you do not have to occupy university lobbies. Men, schnell!
What? What's this? I'm a student here, man. I have rights. What are you doing? Hey!
The WSU lobby fee. Pay it or pay the consequences.
Hello, I'm James Burke. Watch Live at 8, Washington State University's only locally produced comedy show, every Friday night at 8, right here on Cable 8. Who writes this stuff?
Welcome back, everybody. We have with us Kevin Brockschmidt. Kevin is the editorial cartoonist for the Daily Evergreen, and a fine cartoonist he is. Welcome aboard, Kevin.
How are you, Dave?
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Now, first of all, Kevin, is this your first year with the Evergreen?
Yeah, it is.
Really?
This is my first year here at WSU.
Uh-huh. How do you like it?
It's pretty good. I think I'll stay here until I graduate, maybe.
All right. How did you get started in cartooning?
Actually, it's probably a drawing on the living room wall with a bunch of crayons.
Yeah.
My parents didn't want me to have. So.
Yeah?
They made me clean it off.
My mom.
Dampening my career until I got to junior high, I think.
Yeah, and then you like let loose on the junior high teachers and wrote all over their walls?
Yeah.
Yeah. do you plan on making it a living or anything?
Actually, I plan to be a pilot for...
laughing. The guy's serious.
I'm serious, yeah. I've always been pretty good at art, so I decided I'd get a regular degree in art, and if I lose a leg or something when I'm flying, I can go into art, or after I retire. So.
Okay, look, I want to take a look at some of the cartoons that Kevin has done here. Can we take a look at these? Maybe you can tell us a little bit about them. I don't know if there's a lot to explain, but look at these. These are incredible illustrations. Can we get something? Here.
You want me to talk about them?
Yeah, I'd like that. Can we move these over? There we go.
Zoom in.
Yeah. Now, with this, how long have you been getting on with the Evergreen now? I mean,
I just started last semester. And
how'd you do it? You just apply?
Yep, just a regular application.
All right. Can we see this? Okay. There we go.
Okay, this one is my first day in chemistry. 105, and even though I'm not a freshman, I decided most of the kids were freshmen, and actually, you know, how impersonal school is here.
Okay. All right. Let's go with another one here. Let's take a look.
Okay, this is the French administration runaround. This was based on my roommate trying to get financial aid. they kept making him fill out forms and losing all his forms, and so.
You must be a rare case. Okay. All right, let's take a look at a couple more here.
All right, this is a typical Monday morning.
that's pretty good. Okay.
No more needs to be said about that.
Man, there's one on here that you didn't think would get put into this. Is that true, Kevin? You got a cartoon that you didn't think the editors of the
yeah.
actually...
Yeah. Well, it just appeared Wednesday, I believe.
There you go. Yeah. Let's have a look, everybody. Can everybody get a good look at that?
I thought this one was a little bit racy, but apparently everybody gets a big kick out of it.
At Live at 8, we're always up for a good condom joke on that one. So. Okay, let's talk about a couple other things here, Kevin. When did you first realize that you really, you know, you had it? Was that when you were a kid then?
Well, I've always been the best artist in my classes. But mm-hmm. Really, in junior high when I did a cover for a yearbook, and then after that.
Tell us about a couple of your cartoons. I see some here that says the I Don't Care Bears.
Yeah, that was a thing I did my first year of college. And I decided the Care Bears were a little bit too cute, so we came up with I Don't Care Bears, and there's like Drug Pusher Bear and Rapist Bear, things like that.
Okay, what are some of the cartoons you like to look at? You know,
like... I like underground cartoons because they're really, they just can do anything they want and be really silly. So.
Okay. And what's the hardest part of your, you know, of working on the cartoons?
It's coming up with an idea.
Really?
Yeah. Once I get an idea, I can, you know, plug it out in about half an hour. So.
Really?
Yeah. Sometimes it takes a whole day to come up with an idea.
How many can you turn out in a week?
I usually turn out 3, but I can do more if I have to. Or
all right.
If I need more money.
Fantastic. Thanks for coming, Kevin.
Thanks a lot.
All right. Kevin Brockschmidt. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Does this man consistently draw 2,000 students a year to New York's most talked about film class? How does he attract the finest creative talent in the film world? Guests like Woody Allen, Robert De Niro, Martin Scorsese, Dustin Hoffman, Deborah Winger, William Hurt, Steven Spielberg, Robin Williams, Robert Redford, Shirley MacLaine, just to name a few? Why do his students describe him as brilliant, charismatic, and his class provocative, inspiring, exhilarating? Find out for yourself. Richard Brown's Screening Room, a whole new way to look at movies. Watch it on NCTV.
Okay. All right, I want to know how many people here actually had to stand in a lot of lines this time. Seriously, anybody? Let's hear some noise, if you did. Well, a pretty large percentage of our writers spent a lot of time in those lines, and so they have a few beefs. And our resident man on the street, Lee Sandus, has his own opinion about the registration lines.
Thanks, Dave. Well, so here I am, a senior at Washington State University, and you'd think maybe just once I might get my classes. Nope. Of course, I got an add a line, and add a class, that means I've got to stand in line. Yeah, that's right. I got to stand in the business line this time. I got smart this year. I set my alarm for 5 a.m. You know, I'd get an early start. Got up to Todd around 6 a.m. Too bad about 300 people got an earlier start than I did. So I waited. A lot more people showed up around noon. It was nuts, man. The line was all the way out the building. Oh, people were going crazy. This one guy, he was about 4 people up from me. He had to add management 301. Yeah, he ordered a pizza. I called up Domino's and said, yeah, could you deliver a large pepperoni to somewhere between Todd 209 and 211? By 1 o'clock, this one girl, she was waiting for Econ 203. At 1 o'clock, she finally figured out she was in the wrong line. She just threw up her hands and said, I'm going to become a nun. 4 other people at that time joined the service. I just sort of waited. And when I finally got to the Kingdom of Oz, the Promised Land, that golden registration table, they told me my class was closed. Of course, I wasn't going to leave the line without something on my schedule. So I said, what do you got in a 1010 GUR? It was like I was at the shoe store, and a lady came out and she said, hey, we don't have any white Reeboks in your size, but we do have these purple loafers. I mean, you feel like you're in Russia. You know, there's a line. You don't know what it's for. You're just in a line. It's ridiculous. And the registration people, they have this little trick, too. They set up a waiting list for those who persevere, get to the front of the line and find out their class is closed. Yeah, a waiting list. A list of those people dumb enough to wait in the line. I mean, anyone on that list has never, ever gotten a class. I know I never have. And when you sign up for the waiting list, they ask you how many credits you got. Like you're going to tell them the truth. Have you ever noticed everyone on that list has at least 57 credits? Even the freshmen. I mean, it's ridiculous. You know, I got a few ideas about how the whole system could be improved, but I'm not going to waste my breath. Heck, I'm a senior, and that's the last time I'm going to have to wait in the business line. I'm Leif Sandus.
All right, thanks, Lee. While we're on the subject of registration, people, you know, we're coming back to town now, and popular places to meet other people range from, God, I don't know, supermarkets to the clubs around town. Well, now with the registration lines, there's a great new place to pick up someone from the opposite sex. Let's take a look at what we found out.
Hey, look at her. She could balance my budget anytime.
Thanks. You know, I was just noticing your form. Your bubbles. They're so nicely filled out. This thing. Your registration form.
Thanks.
Yeah. Waiting in line for marketing 360, huh?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I waited for over 6 hours for that class last year. Could be worse, though. You know, in Russia, you have to wait for 6 hours just to get into the market.
Oh, you fool! Don't use humor. Remember Hank Branum's Guide to Meeting Women. Step one, seek common interests.
Waiting in line for marketing 360, huh?
Yes.
I collect goldfish. Do you have any hobbies?
I like to feed goldfish to my pet piranha.
Don't get discouraged. Never let them see you sweat.
I'm cool.
Excuse me?
It's cold in here, don't you think?
A little bit.
Well, here, let me give you my coat.
No, thanks.
Okay. No, really, it's no problem at all. Just let me keep you warm and... Here you go. I see you've already been to the bookie.
Yeah, and they robbed me blind.
Yeah, me too, but, you know, I may have a few extra bookie bucks left for dinner for two.
Thanks, but I don't think my boyfriend would appreciate that too much.
You women! You're all the same! You let us get close enough just so you can rip out our heart and stomp all over it! Well, I hope all your sections are closed!
Is this Marketing 360?
Yeah. You know, I waited for over 6 hours for that class last year. Could be worse, though. You know, in Russia, they have to wait for 6 hours just to get in.
What we have tonight in the ongoing debate between, dormitory living or residence halls, as they're referred to now, and also the fraternities and sororities, we've offered a little time to discuss this. The following is not a paid advertisement. It is an open forum discussing the merits of life in residence halls versus life in a sorority or fraternity. Live at 8 is not responsible for the content, nor does it endorse any one viewpoint.
Hello, I'm Randy Sassler, 24 years old, an English business major, and a responsible college student. I'm also a resident advisor at the Gannon Goldsworthy Complex here on campus. There's a lot to be said for living in the residence halls. Good food, friendly people, and a staff that cares. Additionally, there's a relaxed atmosphere that encourages you to be the individual you want to be. There's a lot of pressure in this world of ours. There's even a lot of pressure here at Washington State University. Being a good student takes time, hard work, and individual goals. Why burden yourself with the additional pressure of conformity? College is a chance to grow, to find out who you are. A shallow, unthinking person might find temporary identity behind some cheap, sewn-on Greek letters. But a real individual will find him or herself in a residence hall. Mr. Ermey?
Thank you, Mr. Sasson. Good evening. My name is Mark Ermey. I'm a sensitive, proud, open-minded, honest member of the Delta Chi fraternity. The best place on campus is in the Greek system. It's the opportunity of a lifetime. Based on the traditions and long-standing history of each house, we stand for the ultimate college education. We here are academics and develop our social abilities for the best university experience possible. Together, each house stands for one another. We act as separate families within the system. We take care of each other. When one of the fraternity members is struggling academically, we help. When a brother is new, we have each other and our Greek community to fall back on. United we stand. Unfortunately, through pervasive, uncultivated jealousy, certain members of the rest of the university community, namely our humble friends, the dormies, try to lower our superior stance by creating an atmosphere of competition where they have nary a foot of competition to stand on. Simple fact, no threats. Rebuttal can be offered, but all rebuttal is held within a moot point. We understand. and we empathize. But, my dorm friends, and we want you to think that you are our friends, the truth hurts sometimes, but isn't it easy to deal with once you realize it, Mr. Staslin?
Ours is a small community, a friendly university nestled quietly in the little but hopeful town of Pullman, Washington. Why, in this small town of love, does an unnecessary animosity exist? I speak, of course, of the bitter hatred, nay, the envy and smirking jealousy the Greeks harbor toward those shy, brave, but innocent members of the residence halls, those wondrous students commonly and derogatorily referred to as dormies. Let me pose a rhetorical question to you, the intelligent, compassionate, and understanding members of our television audience. If a fat, smelly, drunk frat boy came knocking on your door and asked to take your daughter out, would you let her go? Would you? No, you'd send the family mutt. But that's beside the point here. What I'm trying to say, with as much innuendo as possible, is that we, the morally upright, studious, and well-mannered inhabitants of the residence halls, have had about enough. It's time to stop this unnecessary quibbling, which, I might add, is blatantly perpetrated by the Greek system. Remember, you can pick your friends, and you can pick your nose, but you can't trust a Greek. Mr. Ermey?
Mr. Sassman, it's only funny until someone gets hurt, isn't it? Instead of blatant undertones and lies, why don't the dormers just come out and say it? Hi, we overstepped the boundaries of good taste. Or, hi, we learn the most when we fail. Just think how much we've learned today. These could very well be the models of dorm life. But why, oh, why stoop to their low demeanor? We came together not in the limited wasteland of the Palouse, but all across this great nation. We link together over the entire world. We stand for community, service, academics, and all of mankind. But wait, there's more. Think of that proud moment when a parent realizes that their daughter is going out with a dormie. When oftentimes in situations like these, fathers have been heard to exclaim, "Good God, Martha, get the gun and let's put her out of her misery." But you're not going to catch me stooping to their level. Answering the critics has never been easy, and believe it or not, we have an occasional bad egg. But we solved this problem by creating the de-pledging process. And you guessed it, they once again become dormies. You may see a bad Greek, but you'll never see a badly dressed one.
Well, Mr. Brotherhood, poke me in the eye and call me stupid. I guess if fashion is important to you, then you just better go Greek. I think I'd be a Greek, too, if I wanted to be a Kmart clone. But then I'd have to worry. But then I'd have to worry about being de-pledged if I missed the blue light. Attention, Kmart shoppers, in the men's department. And let's talk about open-mindedness. Fraternal definition of open-mindedness is a Greek cute girl with an IQ of gravel. I think brotherhood is nothing more than a load of Baha loney. And let's not forget about sororities. I have yet to meet a sorority girl who isn't everything a man could want in a woman, plus about 35 pounds. I'll leave you with this short tale. I had a Greek friend once. He died in a car crash. Now there's a story with a happy ending. Any last comment, Mr. Screaming Frat Fanatic?
Mr. Saslin, once again, dormies and their painful, decrepit rectal itch. My conservative viewpoint has begun to be eaten away. My sense of open-mindedness has just closed. Kmart, you dare use Kmart. Dormy ideals in the height of dormy intelligence. Let me use words the residents might better understand. Oh, yeah. I'm Greek, and I'm still better than you. Well, Mr. Bend Over, I'll drive. Mr. Social Doorknob, will you be my fingerprints? Mr. If personality were waist size, I'd be swimming in sociality. I am Greek, and I am better than you, and I am proud to be an elitist in this Pullman society. Thank you very much.
This is WSU's Cable 8 service, the University Station.
Okay, in case you did not get a chance to figure out who those two friendly people were, that was Mark Ermey and Randy Salson. Both. Oh, I'm sorry, Saslin. I messed it up. Both of them were entered in the Goldsworthy Comedy Competition. Matter of fact, they were the only two entrants, and they won it. But, hey, they're fantastic. They would have won it outright anyway. Okay. On behalf of everyone here at Live at 8, I'd like to tell you that we are psyched about this semester. It's going to be a great semester. I hope this show has given you some idea of what we're all about. Be sure and join us every Friday night at 8, and we even have reruns at like 9:30 or something. We'll see you next time. Kevin Brockschmidt. Kevin is the editorial cartoonist for the Daily Evergreen, and a fine cartoonist he is. Welcome aboard, Kevin.
How are you, Dave?
Yeah. Yeah. All right. Now, first of all, Kevin, is this your first year with the Evergreen?
Yeah, it is.
Really?
This is my first year here at WSU.
Uh-huh. How do you like it?
It's pretty good. I think I'll stay here until I graduate, maybe.
All right. How did you get started in cartooning?
Actually, it was probably a drawing on the living room wall with a bunch of crayons.
Yeah.
My parents didn't want me to have. So.
Yeah?
They made me clean it off.
My mom.
Dampening my career until I got to junior high, I think.
Yeah, and then you like let loose on the junior high teachers and wrote all over their walls?
Yeah.
Yeah. do you plan on making a living or anything?
Actually, I plan to be a pilot for,
The guy's serious.
I'm serious, yeah. I've always been pretty good at art, so I decided I'd get a regular degree in art, and if I lose a leg or something when I'm flying, I can go into art, or after I retire. So.
Okay, look, I want to take a look at some of the cartoons that Kevin has done here. Can we take a look at these? Maybe you can tell us a little bit about them. I don't know if there's a lot to explain, but look at these. These are incredible illustrations. Can we get something here?
You want me to talk about them?
Yeah, I'd like that. Can we move these over? There we go.
Zoom in.
Yeah. Now, with this, how long have you been getting on with the Evergreen now? I mean,
I just started last semester. And
how'd you do it? You just apply?
Yep. Just a regular application.
All right. All right. Can we see this? Okay.
Okay.
There we go.
Okay. This one is my first day in chemistry, 105, and even though I'm not a freshman, I decided most of the kids were freshmen. And actually, you know, how impersonal school is here.
Okay. All right. Let's go with another one here. Let's take a look.
Okay, this is the French administration runaround. This was based on my roommate trying to get financial aid. they kept making him fill out forms and losing all his forms and stuff.
You must be a rare case. Okay. All right, let's take a look at a couple more here.
All right, this is a typical Monday morning.
that's pretty good. Okay.
No more needs to be said about that.
Hey, there's one on here that you didn't think would get put into this. Is that true, Kevin? You got a cartoon that you didn't think the editors of the actually.
Yeah. Well, it just appeared Wednesday, I believe.
Here you go. Yeah. Let's have a look, everybody. Can everybody get a good look at that?
I thought this one was a little bit racy, but apparently everybody gets a big kick out of it.
At Live at 8, we're always up for a good condom joke on that one.
Yeah.
So. Okay.
With an idea.
How many can you turn out in a week?
I usually turn out 3, but I can do more if I have to. Or
all right.
If I need more money.
Fantastic. Thanks for coming, Kevin.
Thanks a lot.
All right. Kevin Brockschmidt. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
does this man consistently draw 2,000 students a year to New York's most talked about film class? How does he attract the finest creative talent in the film world? Guests like Woody Allen, Robert De Niro, Martin Scorsese, Dustin Hoffman, Deborah Winger, William Hurt, Steven Spielberg, Robin Williams, Robert Redford, Shirley MacLaine, just to name a few. Why do his students describe him as brilliant, charismatic, and his class provocative, inspiring, exhilarating? Find out for yourself. Richard Brown's Screening Room, a whole new way to look at movies. Watch it on NCTV.
Okay. All right, I want to know how many people here actually had to stand in a lot of lines this time. Seriously, anybody? Let's hear some noise, if you did. Well, a pretty large percentage of our writers spent a lot of time in those lines, and so they have a few beefs. And our resident man on the street, Lee Sandus, has his own opinion about the registration lines.
Thanks, Dave. Well, so here I am, a senior at Washington State University, and you'd think maybe just once I might get my classes? Nope. Of course, I got an add a line, and add a class, that means I've got to stand in line. Yeah, that's right, I got to stand in the business line this time. I got smart this year. I set my alarm for 5 a.m. You know, I'd get an early start, got up to Todd around 6 a.m. Too bad about 300 people got an earlier start than I did. So I waited. A lot more people showed up around noon. It was nuts, man. The line was all the way out the building. Oh, people were going crazy. This one guy, he was about four people up from me. He had to add management 301. Yeah, he ordered a pizza. I called up Domino's and said, yeah, could you deliver a large pepperoni to somewhere between Todd 209 and 211? By 1 o'clock, this one girl, she was waiting for Econ 203. At 1 o'clock, she finally figured out she was in the wrong line. She just threw up her hands and said, I'm going to become a nun. Four other people at that time joined the service. I just sort of waited. And when I finally got to the kingdom of...
4 years old, an English business major, and a responsible college student. I'm also a resident advisor at the Gannon Goldsworthy Complex here on campus. There's a lot to be said for living in the residence halls. Good food, friendly people, and a staff that cares. Additionally, there's a relaxed atmosphere that encourages you to be the individual you want to be. There's a lot of pressure in this world of ours. There's even a lot of pressure here at Washington State University. Being a good student takes time, hard work, and individual goals. Why burden yourself with the additional pressure of conformity? College is a chance to grow, to find out who you are. A shallow, unthinking person might find temporary identity behind some cheap, sewn-on Greek letters. But a real individual will find him or herself in a residence hall. Mr. Ermey?
Thank you, Mr. Sasson. Good evening. My name is Mark Ermey. I'm a sensitive, proud, open-minded, honest member of the Delta Chi fraternity. The best place on campus is in the Greek system. It's the opportunity of a lifetime. Based on the traditions and long-standing history of each house, we stand for the ultimate college education. We here are academics and develop our social abilities for the best university experience possible. Together, each house stands for one another. We act as separate families within the system. We take care of each other. When one of the fraternity members is struggling academically, we help. When a brother is new, we have each other and our Greek community to fall back on. United we stand. Unfortunately, through pervasive, uncultivated jealousy, certain members of the rest of the university community, namely our humble friends, the dormies, try to lower our superior stance by creating an atmosphere of competition where they have nary a foot of competition to stand on. Simple fact, no threats. Rebuttal can be offered, but all rebuttal is held within a moot point. We understand, and we empathize. But, my dorm friends, and we want you to think that you are our friends, The truth hurts sometimes, but isn't it easy to deal with once you realize it? Mr. Staslin.
Ours is a small community, a friendly university nestled quietly in the little but hopeful town of Pullman, Washington. Why, in this small town of love, does an unnecessary animosity exist? I speak, of course, of the bitter hatred, nay, the envy and smirking jealousy the Greeks harbor toward those shy, brave, but innocent members of the residence halls, those wondrous students commonly and derogatorily referred to as dormies. Let me pose a rhetorical question to you, the intelligent, compassionate, and understanding members of our television audience. If a fat, smelly, drunk frat boy came knocking on your door and asked to take your daughter out, would you let her go? Would you? No, you'd send the family mud. But that's beside the point here. What I'm trying to say, with as much innuendo as possible, is that we...
They're closed!
Yeah. You know, I waited for over 6 hours for that class last year. Could be worse, though. You know, in Russia, they have to wait for 6 hours just to get in.
All right. What we have tonight in the ongoing debate between, dormitory living or residence halls, as they're referred to now, and also the fraternities and sororities, we've offered a little time to discuss this. The following is not a paid advertisement. It is an open forum discussing the merits of life in residence halls versus life in a sorority or fraternity. Live at 8 is not responsible for the content, nor does it endorse any one viewpoint.
Hello, I'm Randy Sasslin, 24 years old, an English business major, and a responsible college student. I'm also a resident advisor at the Gannon Goldsworthy Complex here on campus. There's a lot to be said for living in the residence halls. Good food, friendly people, and a staff that cares. Additionally, there's a relaxed atmosphere that encourages you to be the individual you want to be. There's a lot of pressure in this world of ours. There's even a lot of pressure here at Washington State University. Being a good student takes time, hard work, and individual goals. Why burden yourself with the additional pressure of conformity? College is a chance to grow, to find out who you are. A shallow, unthinking person might find temporary identity behind some cheap, sewn-on Greek letters. But a real individual will find him or herself in a residence hall. Mr. Ermey?
Thank you, Mr. Sasslin. Good evening. My name is Mark Ermey. I'm a sensitive, proud, open-minded, honest member of the Delta Chi fraternity. The best place on campus is in the Greek system. It's the opportunity of a lifetime. Based on the traditions and long-standing history of each house, we stand for the ultimate college education. We here are academics and develop our social abilities for the best university experience possible. Together, each house stands for one another. We act as separate families within the system. We take care of each other. When one of the fraternity members is struggling academically, we help. When a brother is new, we have each other and our Greek community to fall back on. United we stand. Unfortunately, through pervasive, uncultivated jealousy, certain members of the rest of the university community, namely our humble friends, the dormies, try to lower our superior stance by creating an atmosphere of competition where they have nary a foot of competition to stand on. Simple fact, no threats. Rebuttal can be offered, but all rebuttal is held within a mute point. We understand, and we empathize. But, my dorm friends, and we want you to think that you are our friends, the truth hurts sometimes, but isn't it easy to deal with?
Treaty is a step toward world peace. While 95% of WSU freshmen are encouraged that better relations between the two superpowers may lower vodka prices. A few WSU students in the audience tonight? Nationally, freshmen voted flag football as the most popular intramural sport. Here at Washington State, co-ed tag team nude twister barely edged out relay rototilling. Okay, moving on here. 76% of college freshmen nationally polled agreed that the Iowa primary is an important indicator of the outcome of the presidential election. 60% of WSU freshmen responded, quote, Iowa, Indiana, Illinois, hell, all those I states are the same to us.
Ooh, a bowl of chili with hair in it.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, wait, a couple more here. Compared to the national average of 53%, 68% of WSU freshmen disagreed with Gary Hart's pulling out of and re-entering the race. Okay. Nationally, 90% of freshmen polled agreed that the cost of a college education was indeed worthwhile. 95% of WSU freshmen said the rising cost of tuition really crimped their beer money. All right, we have a fantastic show tonight. We have a cartoonist from the Daily Evergreen with us. His name is Kevin Brockschmidt. He's a wonderful drawer. You should see some of the things he draws. We'll have a few things for you if you haven't seen them in the paper. We also have Mark Ermey and Randy Salison. I hope I didn't mispronounce your name, Randy. And they will have a little skit for us. We have got just tons of stuff. Do not go away. Live at 8 will be right back. follow their eyes just skipped over it, and they paid the fee without a second thought. A good move on their part. The following is a dramatization of what happens to those unlucky few who don't pay their optional lobby fee.
Excuse me, sir. Let's see your lobby card.
My what?
Your lobby card. Without it, you cannot occupy university lobbies.
What are you talking about?
If you remember your tuition and fee statement, the part about the lobby fee?
Yeah, what about it?
Did you pay it?
Well, no, it was optional. I don't have to pay.
We get put into this, is that true, Kevin? We got a cartoon that you didn't think the editors of the
actually. Let's well, it up. Just appeared Wednesday, I believe.
Here, there you go. Yeah. Let's have a look, everybody. Can everybody get a good look at that?
I thought this one was a little bit racy, but apparently everybody gets a big kick out of it.
At Live at 8, we're always up for a good condom joke on that one. So. Okay, let's talk about a couple other things here, Kevin. When did you first realize that you really, you know, you had it? Was that when you were a kid then?
Well, I've always been the best artist in my classes. But really, in junior high when I did a cover for a yearbook, and then after that.
Tell us about a couple of your cartoons. I see something here that says the I Don't Care Bears.
Yeah, that was a thing I did my first year of college. And I decided the Care Bears were a little bit too cute, so we came up with I Don't Care Bears, and there's like Drug Pusher Bear and Rapist Bear, things like that.
Okay, what are some of the cartoons you like to look at? You know,
like... I like underground cartoons because they're really, they just can do anything they want and be really silly. So.
Okay, and what's the hardest part of your, you know, of working on the cartoons?
It's coming up with an idea.
Really?
Yeah. Once I get an idea, I can, you know, plug it out in about half an hour. So.
Really?
Yeah, sometimes it takes a whole day to come up with an idea.
How many can you turn out in a week?
I usually turn out 3, but I can do more if I have to. Or
all right.
If I need more money.
Fantastic. Thanks for coming, Kevin.
Thanks a lot.
All right. Kevin Brockschmidt. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Does this man consistently draw 2,000 students a year to New York's most talked about film class? How does he attract the finest creative talent in the film world? Guests like Woody Allen, Robert De Niro, Martin Scorsese, Dustin Hoffman, Deborah Winger, William Hurt, Steven Spielberg, Robin Williams, Robert Redford, Shirley MacLaine, just to name a few? Why do his students describe him as brilliant, charismatic, and his class provocative, inspiring, exhilarating? Find out for yourself. Richard Brown's Screening Room, a whole new way to look at movies. Watch it on NCTV.
Okay. All right, I want to know...
...all day to come up with an idea.
How many can you turn out in a week?
I usually turn out 3, but I can do more if I have to. Or
all right.
If I need more money.
Fantastic. Thanks for coming, Kevin.
Thanks a lot.
All right. Kevin Brockschmidt. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
Does this man consistently draw 2,000 students a year to New York's most talked about film class? How does he attract the finest creative talent in the film world? Guests like Woody Allen, Robert De Niro, Martin Scorsese, Dustin Hoffman, Deborah Winger, William Hurt, Steven Spielberg, Robin Williams, Robert Redford, Shirley MacLaine, just to name a few? Why do his students describe him as brilliant, charismatic, and his class provocative, inspiring, exhilarating? Find out for yourself. Richard Brown's Screening Room, a whole new way to look at movies. Watch it on NCTV.
Okay. All right, I want to know how many people here actually had to stand in a lot of lines this time. Seriously, anybody? Let's hear some noise, if you did. Well, a pretty large percentage of our writers spent a lot of time in those lines, and so they have a few beefs. And our resident man on the street, Lee Sandus, has his own opinion about the registration lines.
Thanks, Dave. Well, so here I am, a senior at Washington State University, and you'd think maybe just once I might get my classes? Nope. Of course, I got an add a line, and add a class, that means I've got to stand in line. Yeah, that's right. I got to stand in the business line this time. I got smart this year. I set my alarm for 5 a.m. You know, I'd get an early start. Got up to Todd around 6 a.m. Too bad about 300 people got an earlier start than I did. So I waited. A lot more people showed up around noon. It was nuts, man. The line was all the way out the building. Oh, people were going crazy. This one guy, he was about four people up from me. He had to add management 301. Yeah, he ordered a pizza. I called up Domino's and said, yeah, could you deliver a large pepperoni to somewhere between Todd 209 and 211? By 1 o'clock, this one girl, she was waiting for Econ 203. At 1 o'clock, she finally figured out she was in the wrong line. She just threw up her hands and said, I'm going to become a nun. Four other people at that time joined the service. I just sort of waited. And when I finally...
Well, I hope all your sections are closed.
Is this Marketing 360?
Yeah. You know, I waited for over 6 hours for that class last year. Could be worse, though. You know, in Russia, they have to wait for 6 hours just to get in.
All right. What we have tonight in the ongoing debate between, dormitory living or residence halls, as they're referred to now, and also the fraternities and sororities, we've offered a little time to discuss this. The following is not a paid advertisement. It is an open forum discussing the merits of life in residence halls versus life in a sorority or fraternity. Live at 8 is not responsible for the content, nor does it endorse any one viewpoint.
Hello, I'm Randy Sasslin, 24 years old, an English business major, and a responsible college student. I'm also a resident advisor at the Gannon Goldsworthy Complex here on campus. There's a lot to be said for living in the residence halls. Good food, friendly people, and a staff that cares. Additionally, there's a relaxed atmosphere that encourages you to be the individual you want to be. There's a lot of pressure in this world of ours. There's even a lot of pressure here at Washington State University. Being a good student takes time, hard work, and individual goals. Why burden yourself with the additional pressure of conformity? College is a chance to grow, to find out who you are. A shallow, unthinking person might find temporary identity behind some cheap, sewn-on Greek letters. But a real individual will find him or herself in a residence hall. Mr. Ermey?
Thank you, Mr. Sasslin. Good evening. My name is Mark Ermey. I'm a sensitive, proud, open-minded, honest member of the Delta Chi fraternity. The best place on campus is in the Greek system. It's the opportunity of a lifetime. Based on the traditions and long-standing history of each house, we stand for the ultimate college education. We here are academics and develop our social abilities for the best university experience possible. Together, each house stands for one another. We act as separate families within the system. We take care of each other. When one of the fraternity members is struggling academically, we help. When a brother is new, we have each other and our Greek community to fall back on. United we stand. Unfortunately, through pervasive, uncultivated jealousy, certain members of the rest of the university community, namely our humble friends, the dormies, try to lower our superior stance by creating an atmosphere of competition where they have nary a foot of competition to stand on. Simple fact, no threats. Rebuttal can be offered, but all rebuttal is held within a mute point. We understand, and we empathize. But, my dorm friends, and we want you to think that you are our friends, the truth hurts sometimes.